Welcome back, you Funko fanatics, to another episode of Man Child Collectibles, the channel where I go through my toy collection, my displays, and any other useless information for your average adults. And I am your host, the Man Child. They always say two is better than one, so on today's episode, we're going to be reviewing my top 10 Funko Pop 2 packs. My top 10 won't be based off of value, but off of the overall design and my own personal preference. So let's get things kicked off with these two nightclub goers that are always constantly striking out with the ladies.
I broke the window again.
Dad's gonna be pissed.
Kicking things off, we got our creepy nightclub duo, Doug Butabi and Steve Butabi. Are they brothers?
No.
Yes!
From one of my favorite SNL skits played by Chris Kattan and Will Ferrell, this two-pack was a New York Comic-Con exclusive. However, the cool thing about this two-pack is how I got it. I didn't get this at one of the shared retail stores. I actually got these guys from the Funko booth at New York City Comic-Con. And no, unfortunately I didn't win the lottery, but it was the last day and they opened up the booth to everyone else so they could sell off what was left over. And fortunately enough, they still had a few of these guys left. Sorry if I ratted out any Funko employees, but also thanks for letting me get in, guys. Coming in at number 9, we got the Grady twins from Stephen King's horror novel, The Shining. There was also a Chase variant of these creepy sisters with blood and pale skins, which was close to impossible to find. I believe there was a 1 out of 36 chance to find the Chase. I was just happy to get the common one since these ladies sold out pretty quick at Target. But mark my words, when I find that Chase for a decent price, it will be mine.
Oh yes, it will be mine.
But overall, I'm just happy I got the common ones. Other than Reagan from The Exorcist, these other two kids creeped me the fuck out growing up when I was a kid. And these two are also the main reason why I still have a little bit of a phobia for hotel hallways late at night.
We're fighters for truth, justice, and the American way.
Up next at number 8, we have Santa Carla's very own vampire slayers, the Frog Brothers from The Lost Boys. These guys were pretty much the comic relief for an 80s vampire film, exaggerating their level of experience and knowledge on their vampire encounters, or better yet, lack of vampire encounters. These guys still ran into the fight with no hesitation. I love the details that they gave to their camouflage clothing, equipped with their wooden stake and a canteen filled with holy water. This two-pack screams the 1980s, which is a huge nostalgia territory for me. Most likely the main reason why these guys made it to my top 10.
The price is wrong, bitch.
One of my most favorite unforgettable cameo appearances in a movie was when Bob Barker beat the shit out of Adam Sandler in Happy Gilmore. When I first saw this fight scene, I was actually surprised how exaggerated it got when it comes to fighting an old man, but my boy Bobby held it down and gave Happy enough of an ass-whooping in this scene. It was a great memorable cameo from Bob Barker in this movie, considering the fact that he was always viewed as a sweet old man hosting a game show all these years. But after this movie appearance, I'm sure no one would ever fuck with Bob Barker ever again, especially if you're playing golf against the guy. Coming in at number 6, we got quite possibly one of the most adorable pops in my collection. It's Carl and Ellie from Up. I don't normally go for Disney's animated pops, but when I saw these two, I just couldn't resist. I absolutely love the pose that they gave Carl of him running around with a balloon. And Ellie with that crazy hair, missing her front tooth, and holding her adventure book? You just can't help but smile when you see this pair. I don't care how cheesy I sound right now, because this two-pack is definitely worthy of my top 10, mainly because they're just too friggin' cute. Coming in at number 5, we got Dwight Schrute and Michael Scott as the Scranton boys from The Office. The comical chemistry between these two is through the roof, and I can never get sick of them, no matter how many times I've relived this show. The design of these guys matches them identically from their horrible attempt of their rap video. Then again, it is Scranton, Pennsylvania, not Compton. And even their poses, with the awkward gang signs that they're trying to throw up, makes this two-pack even funnier than it already is.
Then I'd be spineless, I'm going insane.
I think my mind just goes out of control and touch on subjects motherfuckers read about. I touch on the shit that they be leaving out. I've seen this motherfuckers not smoking. I've seen this, I bet you motherfuckers will too.
At number 4, we got Michael Bolton and Samir from Office Space. This two-pack was from one of the most standout scenes from this movie, when they get revenge of that annoying copier from their office that never worked. The best part about this scene is how they made it look like a mob hit, and their seriousness of how frustrating this copier actually made them. And speaking of which, it's just a nice added plus for this two-pack to include the copier too. This was also an Emerald City Comic-Con exclusive that was released at Target. From what I've heard, most Targets only got 3 of these in, so I was very happy and fortunate to get one for my own.
And she's okay. Game on.
Up next at number 3, we got Wayne and Garth playing street hockey from Wayne's World. When I used to play on the street as a kid, me and my friends would actually yell out "car" and "game on" when the coast was clear. And it was because of this movie. I love the sculpt they did on these two, but the one that stands out to me the most is Garth with his glasses over his goalie mask. Would have been a nice added touch to put the Garth look-alike doll head on his hockey stick. But to be fair, this two-pack was from the first Wayne's World, and the doll head on Garth's hockey stick was from part 2. And I am dying for a trilogy, and I don't care how late it is, just give me a part 3.
Rick? Summer?
At number 2, we got Buff Rick and Buff Summer from one of my favorite cartoons, Rick and Morty. Rick usually takes his grandson Morty on all of his stressful space adventures, but this two-pack was from a Rick and Summer episode when they team up and beat the crap out of the devil. The training montage in this episode was hilarious, where they were pumping iron and taking steroids with DMX music in the background. This was another pretty tough to get two-pack, released in 2017 during Emerald City Comic-Con. This was also a retail release at Target, and most Targets only got 2 or 3 at most, which made this two-pack harder to track down. Fortunately enough, I was the first one at Target when they opened that morning, and this two-pack was definitely worth waking up early to get.
From a certain nearby ringed planet whose name we'd prefer not to mention. My name is Kang, and this is my sister, Kodos.
Hello.
I suppose you want to probe me. Well, might as well get it over with.
And last but not least, at number one, we got two alien siblings from The Simpsons, Kang and Kodos. This glow-in-the-dark two-pack was from 2019 San Diego Comic-Con, and GameStop was the shared retailer that got these in. Unfortunately, I noticed most Comic-Con exclusive two-packs, they only get two or three at most per location. Luckily, I was the third one in line that morning at GameStop, and they only got three that came in. And the two people in front of me went for the other two, so this two-pack was meant to be. And I love the sculpt of them drooling in their space helmets, and how they did their tentacles as a standing base, and the fact that they glow in the dark makes these guys even better. That's why this is hands down my number one Funko 2-pack. And that about wraps up my top 10 list for my Funko Pop 2-packs within my collection. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And thanks again for tuning in to another episode of Man Child Collectibles, the channel where the only way to grow up is to grow up backwards and to always be a kid at heart.